So I want to talk about a very special person in my life who I really idolized and admired, and that is Anthony Bourdain. Now, when I was in university, I kind of didn't really know what I wanted to do, like most people. I wanted to be a teacher, I knew that, but it didn't really excite me that much, except for having summer holidays off. I did love history. I still do, but love being a history teacher or being a coach, something like this. But I quickly became disillusioned with the whole educational process in my university to become a teacher. And also with the school systems in America. This is, you know, No Child Left Behind Act during this time, and it was kind of really getting serious. And the teachers just really didn't have the ability to teach. They were just following the curriculum and rules that the government was setting, and kind of left it to where it was really hard to actually teach what you wanted to teach. And more homework, more tests like this, whatever. And I didn't want to be stuck in one place. I'm a bit of a roamer, a Rolling Stone, you might say. I'm a fan of the 60s, a flower child at heart. But at the same time, I ain't no fucking hippie. Anyways, this is when in university I started watching the Travel Channel. Saw shows like Wild On, you know, the Wild On chick, that really hot chick that would go to all the different clubs and bars around the world to go party. I was like, wow, this is so fun, so cool, going to other countries and experiencing the nightlife and the beautiful women, of course. It's quite interesting. Then I got hooked on the Food Network with Anthony Bourdain and No Reservations. And this guy, to me, was just my hero. Here he is, this just cook, chef, going around the world, eating the most delicious food, and meeting the most incredible people, and writing about it, talking about it, and sharing that with the world. And so this is what I just fell in love with, and from that point was like, I want to do that. That's my dream job. And that's what breaks my heart, too. Especially this year or last year when he killed himself. It's really hard to understand, and you know, even his friends and family can't understand what exactly happened. You know, we all have our inner demons, and you know, the people that were with his girlfriend, crazy bitch. I don't know exactly what went on there. It's a little sketchy, but you know, he had his own demons, and that just goes to show you. No matter what you're doing, where you're at, you always have to take care of the mind, body, and spirit, even if you're doing this kind of dream job thing that you would think is amazing. So how did I end up in China? Well, it's a long story. Let me tell you the short version. When I first set off to teach abroad, because I thought this job would be a great way to travel, earn money, and to be able to live in these countries. Now, it's fun to go to a place for a week or a weekend or whatever, but you don't really touch, you only pretty scratch the surface of that culture, of that place, and of the people. The only way to really get immersed and to understand, even to begin to understand that place, is to actually live there for a long period. Now, when I went to Costa Rica to study Spanish, my last semester in university, and I met the teachers there who were teaching another language, that's when I really fell in love with this job, because they were just communicating, talking with people, and of course teaching them a new language, but also teaching them about the culture, sharing ideas, and teaching them about life also, you know. And we kind of, as a student and teacher relationship, especially for adults, you learn a lot from each other. And this past 6 years when I was teaching adults, I just loved it. I loved communicating. I love talking with people. Sometimes I was kind of like the psychiatrist. Sometimes they were the psychiatrist, and the crazy teacher just ramble on and on, right? So I set off first. I like to go to Japan. I always loved Japan, Japanese anime and the culture of Japan, Japanese women, Japanese food. It's still a place I really want to go to and live someday, but I haven't got there yet. But at that time was the earthquake and the tsunami, the whole radiation scare and whatnot, so I thought it was not a safe place. Yeah. And also Japan, they needed more experience and kind of higher level than I was at the beginning. So then I found Korea, South Korea, as it was a high salary, safe place, cool place. And that's where I went my first year. Now, I absolutely love South Korea. It's one of my favorite places in the world. And hopefully we'll get to go travel there again soon and check that out. I really recommend going to South Korea someday. Through a lot of crap, my work, they were going to close their business. Basically, they had one more month open past my original visa or work visa. And so they asked me, Sean, can you work one more month? Because we're going to close. If you leave, the students have no teacher. And sometimes I'm a sucker for the students, which also happened this last year. But anyways, I said, okay, no problem. But there was a problem. I guess they didn't do the right paperwork. It was illegal or whatnot. I'm not sure exactly what happened. But basically, when I tried to go back to Korea after returning home for about 6 months to take care of my mom, sorry, this is a long story in the short way. Yeah, I couldn't go back. And that's a story in itself. Maybe I'll share another time. So I had to choose a new place. I don't know, Taiwan, Thailand, Vietnam, China, of course, Saudi Arabia. These are all choices. Sometimes too many choices as an English teacher working abroad. You have so many options, so many cities, so many schools. It's really hard. And you just kind of hope that God will show you where to go, or you have that inner feeling of where the perfect place for you at that time may be. But to be choosy, don't just go at the first option like I kind of did my first year in Korea. But even that worked out, so hey, you just got to get lucky sometimes. So I didn't know what to choose. At the time, I also read a book about China before I went to Korea, actually, and this book called Planet China. And just talked about all the craziness China was going through. That was about 12 years ago. So at that time, yeah, China was like the Wild West. It was growing so rapidly. It still is now. But at that time, of course, it was pushing to be the competition that it is today with the U.S. and the rest of the world. And he talked a lot of bad things. Of course, at that time, they didn't care about the environment. People were very uncultured. Now it's changed a lot. In 10 years, 1 year in China is like 5 back home. You know, it's just crazy how fast things changed here. From farmland to mega metropolis city in just a few, just a decade or so, you know. So, anyways, so going back, I was trying to choose a place to teach. I didn't know. Taiwan was on the radar. Thailand, That's when my friend Marlon, who we'll meet someday, he called me and said, Sean, yo, come to Wenzhou. I said, cool, man. Where's Wenzhou? I don't know Wenzhou. He said, it's very nice. And on the online, I found the Sichuan, Chengdu, Chongqing. These are probably the best places to go to in China as far as food and culture and girls and pandas. But he was like, no. Wenzhou's also cool. He was at a job here, so he couldn't leave at that time. And he said, also, the women are very beautiful here, which he was right about. So, okay. I thought it'd be best to come to a place where I had a good friend. And Marlon's been my friend from university. We both studied education in the university, and we both decided to be... He's the one who first introduced me to teaching abroad because his sister had done it, so... We're kind of like brothers in arms in this kind of war on the lack of knowledge of English. So we're teaching them all about the American culture, one class at a time. Yeah. So yeah, he's my good friend. So I came to Wenzhou and I've been here ever since. So I'm really happy I came. China, it makes you crazy sometimes. You know, you always go through those ups and downs as an English teacher living abroad, or expat living abroad, of missing home, thinking this is the most wonderful place in the world, to wanting to get the hell out of here, to so tired of this shit, the noisy and polluted and everything else that goes with it, to just kind of being like, you know, you can make a home out of anywhere, and once you get friends and good people, and you get know your way around. And believe me, living in China is just so convenient that, you know, you really can't compare it to many other places in the world. besides your Singapore's, Japan's, and Korea maybe, and so on. So I'm here. I hope you enjoyed my story. Going back to it, though, I just want to say what I'm all about. I'm a foodie at heart, with an interest in the culture and the people and the things that's going on in our world. You know, now it's going to be 2021. We had a really hard year. 2020 was one hell of a year. I know we're all suffered in one way or another, some more than others, but we just got to keep on going. You know, it's the sun keeps on shining. The winter solstice is over. Now the days will get longer and longer. Things will get better someday. You know, humans, we've been around a while. Not as long as you'd maybe think. But we survived many catastrophes, apocalypses, from the Black Plague to the, you know, Younger Dryad period to who knows how many other catastrophic events and epidemics that have plagued our world. So we'll survive. Suffering is part of it. Maybe this is the Earth's way of kind of healing itself. You know, we got too many people on this planet doing the wrong things, going about living the wrong way. So this is a big wake-up call. It's going to be rough. It's going to be hard. We can't do the things we used to do and take for granted, but we can still do something special. We can still love each other. We can still learn something, and we can still break those walls. All right, guys, thank you so much. Hope you enjoyed. Please like and subscribe to the channel. Leave a comment down below. Love you guys. Happy New Year. Peace.